Good morning, YouTube. So we're here on the home automation controller screen, and I wanted to talk a bit about this home energy monitor generation 5. So this is from Aeotec, and I've had a number of these over the years. These home energy monitors all look pretty much the same. They haven't changed the external appearance, but they've changed the way they work inside. I started out with the Generation 1 device back in 2013, I believe. I think it has an option for battery power, or there's a little 5-volt DC wall supply you can plug in. At least in the US version, it has two current transformers that you put in your breaker panel and monitor line 1 and line 2. Yeah, so one of the quirks with the Generation 1 device is that you actually have to enter the voltage. So for the US, you enter 120 volts because this device doesn't measure the voltage. It only measures the current. And then because of that, it doesn't know anything about like power factor. All it sees is the AC current through the current transformers, and it then multiplies that current by 120 volts to get watts. It also has no idea which way the power is flowing. That device was pretty primitive. So a few years later, I picked up the Generation 2 device, and that one has a built-in AC power supply. You put the two current transformers on. So here's my breaker panel, and I have the two current transformers inside. The home energy monitor just hangs down here on the wall, and there's a power cord that runs over and plugs into an outlet. And show you what the current transformers look like. I have line 1 on this wire coming in, and then I used to have the line 2 transformer over here, but I had to move it up here, and I'll talk about that in a little bit. But that's the way you install these. You just clip these two current transformers around the incoming wires in your breaker panel. You run those wires outside, and you put the unit outside and plug in the power down here. So with this unit, if we look at the device options, you no longer had to tell it what the voltage was because it knew what the voltage was. I think it was a little more accurate because, number one, they could actually measure the actual voltage instead of just a constant number. And then they likely also could measure power factor and adjust for the power factor. But one of the problems with this meter is it didn't measure the direction of power flow. It just assumed power was coming into the panel. That meter didn't know if power was going in or out. With this diversion load project, one of the things I did was I upgraded to this Generation 5 home energy meter because it was supposed to have the capability of measuring positive and negative power flow. So that's one of the reasons I had to move this current transformer up here from down here, because you have to get the direction of current flow proper way. So these transformers are marked with in and an outside. So I put these little arrows on there to say the power is coming in from the grid, it comes down here and then into the breakers. And in order to get the line 2 transformer oriented the right way, I had to actually put it up here above the main breaker instead of down here, because if it was down here, it was going to be backwards and measuring the power flowing out. Here's the installation manual. You can see here they have the clamps marked K and L for the direction of current flow, and you have to make sure line 1 is coming in and then the line 2 is going out, because on the US power connection you've got essentially the neutral is in the middle, line 1 is off to one side, and 180 degrees out of phase is line 2. So you've got to actually flip the line 2 transformer relative to the line 1 so that they're both in phase, and then the meter is running off of a line 1 circuit. And I hooked all that up and paired the unit with my controller, and I got positive power. So what the previous home energy meters did was they just did absolute value of the power. So the power was always positive no matter which way it was flowing. And I looked into the user's manual or the technical manual, and there's this parameter 2. So this is the parameter number definitions, the parameter number, the description, the value, and the size. Yeah, if we scroll down here, there's this new parameter number 2, which says power and energy detection mode. So 0, which is the default, is report power and energy absolute value. And that's what the previous meters did. Then there's this mode 1, which says positive negative power and algebraic sum of energy. And then there's these two other modes, 2 and 3. One is report positive negative power, but only report positive or imported energy. And mode 3 is only report exported energy. But both of them say positive negative power. Of course, when you plug the meter in, you get this mode 0. I'm pretty sure I tried mode 1, but I must have either not got it configured right or didn't test it right. So then I decided to try mode 2, which I thought would actually be the same thing, report positive negative power, because that's what I want to do with the diversion load. Is I don't want to export any energy. I want to use it all internally. So anyway, like I said, I had switched over to mode 2. So again, I don't know if I was not testing it right or something was amiss. You know, after I had that problem about a month ago, June 17th, I posted on the ESLO community forum. They're the ones that acquired Vera. I always see 0.000 watts when there's negative power flowing. And then I see positive numbers when power is flowing in. But I made a support request on the ESLO site and told them same problem. Number one, they came back and said, why would anybody be interested in negative power? That's the craziest thing they'd ever heard of. And they said, well, we're not supporting the Vera firmware anymore, or we're not updating it, so no chance that it ever works, but we'll give you a discounted price on a new controller. And so I asked them, you know, would the new controller support negative power readings? And they came back and said, nope. It won't do it either, but you can request that we add that feature. But then, the funny thing was, out of the blue, I get a report from this guy, Tin Man, on the ESLO forum. And he said he plugged one in 2 years ago and probably found the same thing I did, was he was getting negative power because one of his current transformers was backwards. And then he basically turned the CT around and was getting only the positive readings. But that gave me a clue that, oh, it is possible. And I asked the guy what mode he was using. He said he hadn't changed any modes, but I bet he did. And he gave me his report flags or bit fields here. Anyway, what I did was I thought, you know what? This description in the manual might not be correct, or the device is not working like the manual says. So I'm not sure if it's a documentation problem or a firmware problem. But if you read this, only report energy positive part. And if you apply that to power, here it's power, energy, absolute value. Here, positive, negative power and algebraic sum of energy. And then here, I'm guessing they really meant only report positive power and energy, only report negative power and energy. I went and tried mode 1, and I had some trouble getting that to take. I had to enter mode 1 several times. I'll show you where that is. It's under device options, and that's this right here, 2, energy detection mode. I was running 2, I would enter 1, save changes, and I kept getting errors. Error setting user configuration when you would do that. After like 15, 20 minutes, I would come back to the screen and it was still two. So I'd enter one again, save changes, go away for half an hour, I'd come back, it was still two. So I kept changing it to one, saving the changes, and then all of a sudden it took. And it was like, okay, now I've got mode one running. And as soon as I did that, I started seeing negative numbers here. And so I think that was the problem. I just probably didn't wait long enough here for this mode one to take effect. So yeah, let's see if we can get negative power showing up here, gradually increasing. It usually has to get up a little over 900 watts before it starts generating. You can see we're pulling a little bit of power from the utility. That's the proof that it does work, so you do get the negative readings there. The other reason I wanted to make this video was to explain why I've gone through several iterations of this code. And it looks like right now I've still got a bit of a problem. We're stuck here at 1%, and I'm not sure exactly why, but my original code from several years ago was written based on the generation 2 meter that only reported absolute value power. So it was always positive. And so that code, I had to be very careful never to go negative. So I would always check, did I go below 25 watts? And if I did, I better do something to prevent it from going below zero. So I always tried to keep the power between 25 and then 50 watts. And I had the meter set up to report 25 watt changes. If the power changed by more than 25 watts, it would send out a report. So I had everything based on that. I figured if it went below 25, I was getting close to zero. And if it went above 50, I was getting away from zero. And then I went to the generation 5 meter. And originally I had it working to where like this number would actually read out 0.000 when I was in mode 2, which is only report imported energy. So then I modified the code to work off of 0.000. I assumed the power was negative, and then I would step up the diversion load by like 5% increments, and I would keep incrementing the load until this number went positive, and then I would stop. But now with the true negative numbers, I can take this negative 48 and I could say divide this by 6 and come up with an actual number to put in here. So yeah, if I go to like 8%, I went to 9, 54 watts. Now you can see this should go close to zero because I added 54 watts of load. Let's see what this does. Well, we went to 33, so I have to go up another 5. So let's go to 14. Now let's see. So this is basically the way the diversion code works. So we're still minus 9, so let's add another percent. Maybe add 2%, try to get ahead of it here. See if we can get up to plus. Nope. You can see the power is still building. So we have to go up another 1. Let's go up 2%, and we'll see what that comes out to there. Yeah, now we're finally positive. So you can see I can get positive numbers and negative numbers just by adjusting this slider to use up any negative power here. So yeah, if you have any questions on setting that up, if you need any more details, post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.